Hi, morning. So as the slide says, my name's Mike Miller. I ran Google's operations in Ann Arbor and here in Michigan for the last 8 years. I just relocated to Colorado to help build part of our operation out there. I found Brian's talk pretty interesting this morning about technology being a big driver of what happens in change, both in society as well as in the office. And that's what I've spent my 17 years in technology doing. I'm actually a history major. I come more from the business side than from the engineering side. And through my work, I've worked with businesses about how does technology ultimately change what we do. Well, it was 11 years ago this week that I received an offer and accepted it to go work at Google. Although I'd hardly argue that I'm a smart creative, as Eric Schmidt was quoted earlier, saying about our company. And when I joined, I sat in an office that was about the size of this table with two other people. And the technology we used was pretty state-of-the-art for the time, 11 years ago. I traded in my Palm Trio for a BlackBerry. I had my IBM ThinkPad. I had a little Sprint card that I could plug in to access the internet if I were going outside of the office. Video conferencing was starting to come in to our office. Although now we've got it working a little better than Brian described earlier, it does work reasonably well. And you might have heard things like voice over internet coming online at that point in time. So it seemed like technology was moving pretty well. But when you zoom out 11 years ago and look at where technology was, it's pretty fascinating. At that point in time, there were 1.1 billion users of the internet out of 6.6 billion people globally. So only 10 years ago, about 17-18% of the world was online at that point. If you look at e-commerce, obviously that we're heading into the holiday season, that is a big focus right now. E-commerce 10, 11 years ago, was roughly about $100 billion in the United States, about 2.7% of overall retail sales. Still pretty small at that point in time. And then if you look at one of the biggest trends right now, mobile, it was in its infancy. So anyone know what the hottest phone was in 2006? It was a flip phone, Sandy. Yes. Do you know which one? The Motorola Razr, if anyone had the Razr. But about 50 million of those were sold in about a two-year time period. And the hottest consumer device that holiday season, 11 years ago, any guesses as to what that was? Sandy? An MP3 player. About 50% year-on-year growth for MP3 players 11 years ago, right now. So that was the state of the art for technology. Now, the other interesting part about that time period, 2006, there was a lot happening kind of behind the scenes, things that weren't necessarily on the radar. So that was the year that Facebook opened up beyond college campuses. You had to be 13 years or older, and they opened it up to the world. Twitter started that fall. Amazon Web Services started earlier that year. And online video had started to take off. In fact, we bought YouTube earlier that year because of the growth that was happening at that point in time. But perhaps the most important one was not in 2006, but in early 2007. In January of that year is when Apple announced the iPhone. And then we followed later that year by announcing Android. So we were on the precipice of going from flip phones to smartphones at that point. So let's fast forward 10 years. What do we look like right now on some of those statistics? On internet usage, we've gone from 1.1 billion people using the internet 10, 11 years ago to now somewhere about 3.5, 3.6 billion people using the internet. Now, the world has grown by a billion people in that time period also. So we've roughly gone from about just under 20% of internet usage up to almost 50% in that 10-year span. Huge shift for us. And obviously something that drives even the trends that Brian was talking about earlier. If we talk about retail and e-commerce, we've also seen big shifts. So we've gone in the US estimates are that we'll do about $400 billion in e-commerce this year, from $100 billion 10 years ago. So you've had double-digit growth throughout that entire time period. And it continues. It's actually ticked back up. It dipped in 2011, 2012 to lower teens from a growth rate standpoint, and now it's actually going back up. When you look globally, it's been even more explosive. So estimates are that we'll do $2 trillion worth of e-commerce this year globally. China's a huge driver of that. India's coming online, et cetera. But yet we're still only, from a penetration standpoint, in the low teens from over a percentage of overall retail. So there's still a lot more to be done there. And then in mobile, we've gone from the flip phone and the Motorola Razr in 2006 to now having 2.8 billion smartphones in circulation across the globe in a 10-year span. But if you look against the total population, that's only about a little bit under 40% of the world still has a smartphone. We still have a lot of room to run on that. And estimates are that in the next 3 years, we may double that amount. So we've been in a mobile revolution for almost a decade, but it still is continuing in that regard. Now, the other big piece that's happened in the technology side is the transformation of platforms. So if you look at Google 10, 11 years ago, we were principally a search company. Right? That was our core business. If you look at us now, we've got 7 platforms where we have over 1 billion users each. Things like Search, Chrome, Android, Gmail, Maps, the Google Play Store, and YouTube all have over 1 billion users each. And the same thing happens with Facebook. They announced earlier this year they've got 2 billion users on their platform. WhatsApp, one of their other platforms, has over 1 billion users. And then you've got Twitter, Snap, Instagram, all with hundreds of millions of users. And that has all happened within a 10-year span. But there's still more that will continue on that path. Now, obviously, as that has transformed, we've transformed too. Brian talked a bit about this earlier. If you look at our user habits, both as consumers as well as individuals, those have shifted pretty dramatically in that time period. eMarketer puts out information on a regular basis about what our usage patterns are on digital media. So if you go back to 2008, the average US adult, would have spent about 2.5 hours a day on digital media. And about 80% of that would have been on a laptop or a desktop, probably at work, more than likely. Right? Maybe a little bit of e-commerce, some email, things of that sort. Well, in that really 8-year span from 2008 to 2016, which is the most recent data, that has more than doubled. So we now, as an average US adult, we spend over 5.5 hours a day on digital media. And I could see many of you on it right now. So. Which is fine. We encourage that at Google. But 5.5 hours a day. And by the way, TV has not decreased that much in that time. It's only dropped significantly, a little bit. We still spend about 4 hours a day on TV. Now, some of that obviously overlaps. So think about those changes. Mobile, again, as a big theme, has seen the most dramatic shift. So if you go back to 2008, on average, we would have spent about 30 minutes a day on mobile devices, right? Probably email at that point in time. Now it's 10x in that time period, in an 8-year time period. We now spend over 3 hours a day on mobile, right? So email is a big piece of that. Apps, I can see everybody's on their apps right now, which is good. Video is a big one. Texting, as you're doing with the surveys that come up throughout the session. So think about that type of transformation. Now, that has also changed what we do online. So if you look at it from a Google standpoint, we now see billions of searches a day, trillions in a year. People are using it to find information. For something like online video, we've gone from it being fairly small back when we bought YouTube, to now over 1 billion hours of watch time a day globally. 1 billion hours a day. And half of that is consumed on a mobile device. So chances are half of this group was watching some form of online video on their mobile device at some point today. Or maybe your kids were, or relatives, et cetera. Apps are obviously a huge part of that consumption now. That is something we didn't have 10 years ago. That has transformed into a billion-dollar plus market at this point. So big shifts. Now you have to go, you can go a little deeper. It has actually transformed us as individuals too. And we can see it in our search data. So now we have an inclination to search for even pretty mundane things. Things like toothpaste, olive oil, and umbrellas, right? Pretty basic things, have all seen triple digit increases in their searches through the first part of this year. So what used to be you were price checking a car or a big purchase, now you are probably price checking to see how whether that is a good umbrella when you are in the store purchasing it. We also see a change in immediacy. So we see a big shift in searches for things like same-day shipping. We see stuff and we want it now. Something like hotel room tonight has seen a big shift in its searches, right? We've applied that sense of immediacy even to things that we used to probably plan for well in advance. So it is fundamentally changing how we think about and interact with the technology. Now, as businesses, if you're in the consumer side, obviously this has changed quite substantially over time, right? We know that online retail has changed. You need to be where your customer is, but now you need to be thinking about what are they looking for? When are they going to buy it? How available is it? We have research that shows that if a mobile site doesn't load, it takes only a couple of seconds to load and is slow, a consumer will abandon it. We are impatient, down to the seconds now because of the immediacy part. So if you have a business that has a mobile site and it doesn't load fast, that consumer is going somewhere else. Maybe to Amazon, maybe to another competitor, et cetera. Something that you need to think about from a business standpoint. On the B2B side, I led parts of our B2B business at Google over the years. We've done a lot of research in this space also. So if you're in the B2B market, this also applies. If you went back 8-10 years, we would not have seen deep internet penetration on the B2B side. You still would have relied on a sales force or on some deeper connection with your customer set. But now what we're seeing is that what happens on the consumer side feeds into it. And we started to see those shifts about 5 years ago. So we did a piece of research 5 years ago that basically showed that a buyer was about 57% of the way through the buying path before they would even reach out to a company. They were doing all of that research online, maybe through your website, through another website, through other means at that point in time. And that's only gone up since then. If you look just a few years ago, they would have started to come into digital and use things like search, which were available, or web pages, et cetera, to be able to find information out. But they would not have been using things like mobile or video. And in the last basically 2 years, that has transformed also. So we did a piece of research about 3 years ago that showed that in the B2B space, so a buyer looking to purchase from another company, they would have, only 1 in 10 would have used video at that point. Well, 2.5 years later, it was almost 70% of B2B buyers were using video somewhere in the buying process. And it wasn't just one. So 50% of those were watching video for over a half hour, and another 20% were watching it for a full hour. So what has happened in the consumer world has certainly moved radically into the B2B world. And then mobile devices, too, have had incredible penetration from a B2B standpoint. So we went from having, 5 years ago, 25% penetration there, where a B2B buyer would say, I'd use a mobile device in my buying path, to now over 80%, right? And you're witness to that, given the number of devices that are in the room today. So what we see happening in the consumer world is now fully made its way into the B2B space. Now, as you go forward, these are some of the big things that you need to think about. We still have a lot of room to run as it relates to the internet, right? With only 50% of the world's population being online, we still have significant growth there. mobile is still, although it's not necessarily in its infancy, it's still somewhat in its early days. There's still huge growth there, both in the developed world and in the developing world. And then obviously the rise of platforms is changing the way in which technology works, both in the workplace and with consumers. So one question you have to ask yourself is, how are you and your company taking advantage of those, and are you prepared? Because if you're not moving fast, then you're gonna get left behind. But the other thing is to think about what are the seeds that are being planted now. So just as back in 2006, when Twitter started, when YouTube really kind of came online, when Facebook opened up, when the iPhone launched, what are the things today that are now, when we come back for this 16th version of this conference in 10 years, going to be the things that will be highlighted? Right? We see a rise in things like machine learning happening right now, or virtual reality, augmented reality, obviously still fairly nascent in what's happening in those spaces, but the technology there is advancing incredibly rapidly. And we will see where it goes and how it takes hold. Brian talked about Alexa and voice. That is a big one also. So Google Home or the Amazon Echo. You know, if we look at our search app data, we now see about 20% of searches coming from voice, which means we've moved from thumbs to now talking to our devices. So these are the type of trends that we need to be able to watch for. And the question 10 years from now will be, which ones have you taken advantage of with your company, and have you stayed on top? Thank you.